What is the origin of grey eyes? What are some of the differences between grey and blue eyes? And why did grey eyes develop in the first place? Now, grey eyes are generally considered the second rarest eye colour in the world after green, with estimates of around 3% of the global population having them, and they're super rare in the US at less than 1% of the population. An interesting point to note is that grey eyes were actually included in the first ever clinical iris colour classification scale going all the way back to 1843. The scale included 5 colour categories: grey, blue, hazel, brown and black. So how can you tell if you've got grey eyes versus blue eyes? Well, although this isn't an exact science yet, grey eyes tend to have much more of a grey hue to them, and they can also look a bit more cloudy. Under magnification as well, grey eyes often exhibit small flecks of yellow and brown in the iris, with this photo showing that detail quite well. Although people with blue eyes can also have flecks of other colours as well, my eyes are blue for instance, but they do have flecks of yellow in them, although it's hard to see in different lighting scenarios. It is pretty unusual for people with blue eyes to have flecks of brown in them. It can be tricky as well to separate different eye colours, especially in different lighting scenarios. To make matters more confusing as well, there is variations in colour and almost hybrid eye colours, with blue-grey, green-grey, hazel-grey, all variations in hues that are possible. So what is the origin of grey eyes? Well, the first person with grey eyes is unknown, but there may be some connection with blue eyes. With the OCA2 mutation that is at least partly associated with blue eyes, seemingly going back to at least 50,000 years ago. What we do know is that grey eyes, although they are rare, are found in higher rates amongst the Algerian Shawabi people of Northwest Africa, as well as in the Middle East, Central Asia and South Asia. They are also found at relatively high rates in Europe, especially in countries such as Norway, Iceland, Sweden, Ireland and Finland. References to grey eyes can also be found down through history. The Greek goddess Athena, for instance, who takes her name from the ancient Greek city of Athens, was often depicted as having grey eyes, and they have been associated with wisdom. Now let's look at some of the physiological reasons and theories for grey eyes, which further explains how they differ from blue eyes. One theory is that grey eyes have even less melanin than blue eyes, or even no melanin in some cases, and this is what causes them to appear lighter than blue. Melanin obviously refers to a family of biomolecules that control the level of pigment that gives hair, skin and eyes their colour. Although there definitely needs to be more research into grey eyes in general and their melanin concentration in particular, it would make sense from a logical perspective that grey eyes have less melanin than blue eyes given that they're lighter. In general, compared to other eye colours, and from the information we have at the moment, brown eyes have the most melanin, followed by hazel eyes, then green eyes, then blue eyes, and grey eyes may be right at the bottom with the least melanin. Given this general picture of melanin concentration, it would come as no surprise that people with grey eyes are usually pretty sensitive to light, but more on that later. Now, another defining feature of grey eyes is that they seem to have larger deposits of collagen within the stroma of the iris, compared to blue eyes, that is, and this causes light to be reflected in a different way. It's actually similar or analogous to why the sky looks either blue at different points versus grey at different points. Light that enters grey eyes is thought by some to undergo a process similar to Mie scattering, a process which is not strongly wavelength dependent, whereas light that enters blue eyes is thought to undergo a process similar to Rayleigh scattering, in which shorter wavelengths of light are scattered more, with blue having a short wavelength. Obviously, light itself is made up of a spectrum of colours, as we can see when we're lucky enough to see a beautiful rainbow. Thus, a grey sky, something I'm quite familiar with given that I live in Scotland, is caused by light being scattered relatively evenly off the large water droplets in the clouds when the sky is cloudy. As, once again, the process of Mie scattering is not strongly wavelength dependent, and thus light is reflected more evenly. Whereas a blue sky is caused by light of shorter wavelengths being scattered by small gas particles in the air when the sky is clear, as the process of Rayleigh scattering is wavelength dependent and the colour blue has a shorter wavelength and is also quite abundant. Processes with similar physics is likely a major driver of whether someone's eyes is grey versus blue. As I noted as well in some of my previous videos on eye colours, such as blue, green and hazel, if you were to dissect an eye, you would only find a dark brown pigment in general, irrespective of whether that person had grey, blue, hazel or green eyes. The range of colours we see in eyes is largely to do with how light is scattered within the iris, and this is mainly determined by how much melanin is present. With a complex genetic process that scientists are still trying to fully figure out, responsible for how much melanin is produced, grey eyes obviously seem to have more collagen as well, which affects how light is scattered. As far as the broader reasons for grey eyes, there is obviously a major genetic component, but there hasn't really been too much research specifically looking at grey eyes, although some of the mechanisms involved may be quite similar to blue eyes. And we know that a mutation in the OCA2 gene is one of the drivers of blue eyes, it seems, although there are other genes involved. But could environment play a role in grey eyes developing? Well, from the perspective of those in Northern Europe, in places like Norway and Sweden and Finland, etc., it would make sense that the grey eyes are found to some degree amongst the population, as obviously, as noted earlier, grey eyes are very sensitive to light, and obviously in these places in the winter months, is very low light conditions in parts of Northern Europe. So from that perspective, it would make sense. As I make the argument in my video on blue eyes, which I suggest you watch after this if you haven't seen it already, getting enough light in your eyes is very important for your health and a whole cascade of neurobiological processes. Not getting enough light in your eyes is associated with symptoms of depression, for instance. Anyone who is a follower of the Andrew Huberman podcast, who is a professor of neurobiology and ophthalmology at Stanford School of Medicine, will know the importance of safely getting enough natural light in your eyes early in the day to get a natural spike of cortisol and to clear adenosine out after sleeping the night before. So one could definitely make the argument that grey eyes are quite well suited to Northern Europe, given obviously the climate in the winter months and how sensitive grey eyes are to light. But obviously this argument to do with light doesn't really explain Algeria and the Middle East, the prevalence or relative prevalence, or even though grey eyes are quite rare, but we do see them in Algeria and the Middle East and other parts of Central Asia, etc., that are obviously much warmer climates. So what's going on here? Well, perhaps sexual attractiveness plays a role in these regions. In these places, people tend to have darker eyes, so having grey eyes would make you quite unique. And as we know, human beings tend to value things that are rare. So potentially people with grey eyes were seen as more attractive down through history. Perhaps the higher rates of collagen play some role as well, but like I say, definitely more research is needed into grey eyes to really understand the various mechanisms that are going on. What's your thoughts though? Do you have grey eyes? And if you come across any good research into grey eyes, please let me know in the comments below. As mentioned earlier, grey eyes can often be confused with blue eyes, but what is the origin and reason for blue eyes? To find out, please click here. Thanks for watching, please subscribe and hit the bell, and I'll see you next time.